Led by the Lira City Central Division Police Commander Joseph Bakaleke, the police intercepted the group as they approached Obote Avenue. After the first episode of tear gas, the group retreated backward and Bakaleke addressed them, ordering them to go back to their church.
You move in thousands like this and cover the road. One, you don't only endanger your lives, but you also endanger the lives of other road users. Yeah. What you are doing tantamount to an illegal procession. If there are visitors you are expecting, my request and humble request to you is that you get back to the church. Wait for those visitors from where? From there, my elders.
As they retreated, the group started singing and dancing on the road, promoting Bakaleke to order his officers to fire more tear gas, which forced them to go back to their church. Sam Omara, a senior pastor from Aki Assembly, Yahweh Pentecostal Mission, says they were going to welcome their guests from the president's office when the police attacked and injured some of them.
To go and receive him on the way when he is coming. But unfortunately, we have seen a policeman coming with guns like we are rebels and begin to shoot us without asking us. Unfortunately, one man was shot. And he is now injured. I don't know whether he's going. Three of them are injured.
They are four now.
And I don't know if they are going to survive. Four of them. And police did not come and speak to us and say what is happening. But they come with the order and begin to shoot us. That is what is annoying us this morning.
As the police blocked the march, another group moved in a vehicle to the office of the resident city commissioner to deliver a petition to the president. Lawrence Egole, the RCC, acknowledged receipt of the petition. He apologized for the incident by the police. However, he said it was to restore law and order.
From a team of leaders from LPC, from Yahweh Pentecostal Church, who came to my office this morning with their petition that they want to be delivered to His Excellency the President through the Minister of Presidency. I have received and have pledged to them that I'll make sure the petition reaches the hand of the President through the Minister of Presidency.
As long as our leaders do not speak the truth, the people they lead, then we are bound to continue with this mess on many and regular occasions.
Report compiled by Hudson Apunyo for the news.